Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to convert seconds into hours, minutes and seconds in Python. So let's get started. So first we will be getting the seconds as an input from the user. So let s be my second equal to int of input. It will just have the text enter seconds. So first we will be converting the seconds into hour. So for converting into hour, let me just have a variable equal to seconds, that is our s, double slash 3600. So now let me tell you why I am putting double slash over here, because if we put single slash, it will give us a decimal number. So to avoid that, I am putting a double slash, which basically gives us a whole number. So why I am dividing by 3600 is that 1 hour equal to 3600 seconds. So that's the main reason why I am doing this. And this basically will give us the quotient. So let's suppose say our seconds is going to be like 7200. So in that case, we are having 2 hours in it, because we are having 3600 in 7200. So that's the reason why I'm just dividing it. And you need to put double slash so that we are avoiding getting a decimal number. I hope that made sense. So next thing I am going to show you is converting the seconds into seconds, like the normal time format seconds. So for that, it's going to be second equal to our input seconds modulus of 60. Now we are good with the second, alright. So next is going to be the minute. For minute, we will be having another condition over here, which is going to be our input second equal to input second modulus of 3600. Alright. So let me just now type this line, and later I will be explaining you why we are using this. And at the end, our minute will be equal to minutes equal to our input seconds double slash 60. Alright. So let me just now run it, and later I'll be explaining with the demo how it works. So let me just now print within double quotes, just put percentage D colon, and let me just now copy this and paste it again, and just remove this. Yeah. And I'm going to put a percentage over here, and within bracket, we need to pass R first, comma minutes, comma second. Yeah, so this is fine, I guess. So let me just now save it and run it now. So I'm going to type 3670. So I think this will need to give us 1 hour, 1 minute and 10 seconds. Yeah, so here you can see I've got 1 hour, 1 minute and 10 seconds. So now let me explain you what is the meaning of this particular line. So if I just now cut this line, and if I just now run it, yeah, for the exact same thing, 3670, so we will be getting 61, all right, which isn't a valid minute. So to convert that, so to round off this particular value within its range, within the minute range of 60, we are adding this particular line over here. All right, it's just like a syntax or a formula, that's this thing. But there is still an issue with this code. The issue is that this code works well for second input, which is like a smaller number. So it will work for 3600, maybe 10,000 or 1 lakh. But if it is above that, it will definitely throw you an error. Like, it won't throw an error, it will show you an invalid output. So let me just also show you that. So if I go with such a big number and hit enter, so you will be getting 2700 something hours. But the minutes and seconds are fine. So to avoid this, what you can do is, you can just go to the R over here, and you need to add percentage 24 asterisk 3600. So this 24 basically corresponds to 24 hours of a day. So using this, we can like limit our R within the 24 hour range. So exact same thing here, we are limiting the minutes within 60, right? 60 minutes range. The same thing we are doing for hours. We are just limiting the hours with the 24 limit range. I hope that made sense. So I'm just now saving it and running it now. I will show you two demos. One is for, I will go with 7507. I think we need to get 2 hours, 5 minutes and 7 seconds. Yeah, 257, that's spot on. And let me go with a large number now. Just I will go with one and some zeros like this. So here you can see, this is now within the range, within the hour format. So this is like mostly optional. You can just have, in case if you're having like a large input number, so you can just add this line, and I hope it works. please tell it in the comments. And I hope you have found this video useful. I've also done many other videos in Python, C, C++, Java, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB. So do check other videos off my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.